When you buy back the pork, huh, scrape this. Wash and scrape. You see, all the, this one, this scrape all wrong. This is the second time of scraping. Sell the turkey. Score this. Don't go right inside, just about like, not too deep. Slightly only. Just slightly only. Okay, then put white red wine and then you just soak in the red wine for like, if you don't have time, half an hour, then after that season another 4 hours then you can drink. If not, then I usually like to soak in the wine for longer. Okay? I soak quite a lot of red wine. This is good. Wine that you cannot finish, don't throw, just collect them in a bottle and then it's for soaking meat lah, chicken lah. This one, I use red wine. After come back, I must wash, I must scrape, this one scrape ah. Then cut, score the meat. Then I put red wine and I leave it in the fridge overnight. So when you leave in the fridge, you just cover like that. Okay, now we're going to put the spice powder, pepper and salt. Okay, I always go by like two portion of pepper, then also one portion of salt, okay. And spice powder. Can be a bit lesser because I don't really like so much of the spice powder taste, but still spot okay, like that. I go on more pepper, less salt because after that on the skin there will be more salt. So usually I try to the bottom. Then you can see there. Okay. Then after that, rub into there. Alright, yeah. Okay, flip the skin over. You don't want the red wine on the skin now. Okay. But this one you can still use after that. Spice powder. Yeah. This one massage in. Then the massager is here because his finger don't have all the quickly. So no need to reach the skin at the side and the inside. Then the side skin also no need to reach the skin. Okay, continue. Okay, when you're done rubbing in, get ready your aluminum foil, the shining side facing the meat. Then you come pick up the plate. Pick up the plate. Hey, your hand don't touch this. Put the meat on.
Okay,
no, face down. Okay. Yeah, face down. Yes. Okay, then you can wrap. So when you wrap this, you leave a bit of pack on top. That's for the sock. And then when you put the sock, then push the skin. Push the skin. Then after when you wrap the sock, got one layer here. Actually, this one you can just cut. In fact, that's the red one. Okay. In this goes into the fridge. Minimum 4 hours. You can leave it for. You can leave it overnight. So tomorrow, then you. Tomorrow part 2. One day in season inside the fridge already. Today we're going to do the baking. So this is rough salt. The baby is a boy. cover well, the salt won't go inside. It's just at the side. That's why the aluminium foil is to stop the salt from dropping inside. Like when you cook, inside is broiled. Cook the meat, but the skin don't get cooked, don't get chowed. After that, then you take the skin.
So put all the salt. The salt is to protect the skin, is it? Huh? Yeah. It's not to make the skin taste salty.
Oh,
so I'm learning.
Overcook the skin, right?
I see. So this is to not to overcook the skin while you cook the inner part of the pork belly, the meat portion. Mm.
200 for 1 hour.
Repeat again.
200 degrees. 1 hour.
Okay.
Later finish, take out, scrape away the salt. Pop, pop, pop. Another 20 to 25 minutes in for after 1 hour. Then take water. This one later the oil from the pot will drip inside. If you don't put water, then the whole place will be very smoky. Mm-hmm. When you put water later, the oil just go inside. And not smoky. Okay. So here, turn up maximum.
Maximum.
Okay, then this one. This one can throw away. It's very hot. Don't put in the plastic bin.
Inside is completely cooked already?
Yeah. Inside is completely cooked already. So now, the next step is to make the skin crispy. Don't go too deep also, I want to break into the the fat layer, all the fat pulls up. You want the fat to continue here to cook in its own fats. My cooking, I go one angle, one piece, it's not cooking. Just dip inside, dip inside, dip, dip as much holes as you like. Some part you do is good, it's good. You can even do it twice. Later you can go in, then after that take a poke again. If you see like the bubbles not enough, you can poke again. Yeah, this part is the one that is not covered by the salt. So you see it's like that. You cover the salt, it's soft.
Already looks so beautiful.
The white vinegar.
Must it be this brand?
Yeah, any white vinegar.
Recommended?
I just found it.
1 teaspoon?
Yeah. So,
just drizzle on top.
Okay. So, this one must wait until it heats up to the 250. Mine is 250, some oven 240. Mm. Okay.
Yeah, until when?
Until the red light gone. My oven now. Oh. Okay. Whoever your
so
oven.
We do off, so can put in the pork belly to roast the skin. Wow, wow, Swana, better than worse than Junior Poon House. Huh? Oil can drip down into the water.
Alright.
For how long?
20 to 25 minutes, but you have to keep watching the bubble come up.
20 to 25 minutes and you have to keep on watching the bubble. Let's see, you got bubble or not? Bubble?
Bubbling very well. But this one, the center still not very ready. It's almost ready. If you want it even more crispy, wait for a while. Can afford to wait for another 5 to 10. No, I think maybe 5 minutes or so. This one can wait a bit longer.
See the water evaporated already. And no water inside. Okay.
Like that, huh? Like that, you leave it to
cool down
for 5 to 10 minutes. Don't chop now. Don't chop. Now you chop the water bowl, it stick into the skin, it's no more crispy, it's not soggy.
Okay, remember, rest for 5 minutes.
5-10 minutes.
5-10 minutes. Looks awesome.
What time is it? I think this is done. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Is it done?
More like that then.
But you need to put in another.
Not enough for it. Mm-hmm. Put some more. Can put some more. Can put just can put.
This is Mr. Chef.
Okay.
Happy couple, one bake and one chop.